Hi from The Crafty Co. In this video, I will teach you how to make these gorgeous cotton coasters. They are a fab way to use up all of your scraps of wool and they make great gifts. For this tutorial, I am using a larger hook than I need, simply so that you guys can see what I'm doing with the stitches. I'm working in cotton yarn. Cotton isn't the easiest to work with as it does have a tendency to split, but it doesn't bobble and it's really hard wearing. So we start by working a magic ring and a 3-chain into that ring, which will count as our first treble. Work a further 2 trebles and a 1-chain. That will be our first side of the round. We just repeat this a further 3 times. So we need to do 3 more trebles and a 1-chain. That will be our second side. Three more trebles and a 1-chain. That will be our third side. And 3 more trebles and a 1-chain to complete the round. Pull the magic ring tight and close this round with a slip stitch into the top third stitch of that first dummy treble that we did at the beginning of the round. Cut your yarn and pull it through to secure. In the first round, we created our 4 corners by working a 1-chain after our 3 trebles. We now need to start in one of these corners for the second round. And we start using the dummy treble method. Wrap your yarn twice around your hook. Insert the hook into one of the corners, yarn round and pull through. Yarn round, take off the first 2, make sure you hold tight to that tail, and yarn round, take off the second 2. Keep hold of that tail until we've completed another treble. So we do another treble in the same space, then a 1-chain and 2 further trebles, all in this same space to create our first corner. We now need to work 3 trebles along the side, and for these side stitches we'll be working in the back loop only. The first one is quite hard to locate because it's tucked very close to that first corner that we've created. So we need to work 3 trebles, 1 in each of the stitches down the side, working in the back loop only. We now need to create our second corner, which is the same sequence as the first. 2 trebles, 1-chain and 2 trebles, all in the same space, and that will create our second corner. We continue around the round in the same way, working 1 treble in each of the 3 side trebles from the previous round, and working the same sequence of 2 treble, 1-chain, 2 treble into the same space for the corners. Keep working around until you get to the last treble. And to close the round, we do a slip stitch into the top of that first dummy treble at the beginning of the round. Cut your yarn and pull it through. And that is your second round completed. For the third round, we will work exactly the same as for round two. But as we work more stitches in each corner, it means that we've added two stitches to each end of the four sides. So instead of having three trebles, we will be working seven trebles down each side. So the third round starts off the same as the second with the dummy treble. And the sequence for the four corners in this round is the same. Two treble, one chain, two treble into the same space. The only difference in this round is, as I mentioned before, instead of having three trebles down the sides, due to the two increases at each end, we now have seven trebles. We now need to work along the side, again in the back loop only. And as I've mentioned before, the first one is quite hard because it's tucked right by the corner. Continue along the side working your seven trebles. Working into the back of the stitch gives it a nice little feature. It creates a line at the edge of the work. So we've now completed our seven trebles down the side, and we're going to be working in the corner with the corner sequence of two treble, one chain, two treble. And just work your way around the round using this sequence. Seven trebles down the sides and the corner sequence until you get to that last treble. And as before, join the round by working a slip stitch into the top of the dummy treble at the beginning of the round. And that's round three completed. The fourth round is worked in exactly the same way, but we now have 11 trebles down each of the sides as we've increased another two at each end. The corner sequence remains the same. So we work this round in exactly the same way with the dummy treble at the start, corner sequence, two treble, one chain, two treble, and 11 trebles down each side. But it's basically worked in exactly the same way. We mustn't forget that we are working into the back of the stitch every time. Apart from the corners, that's worked into the corner space. These coasters are really quick and easy to make. You will see that mine look quite open weave, but that is purely because I have used a bigger hook than I actually need to use. I would normally use a 3mm or a 3.5mm hook with this weight of cotton. Working the double treble at the beginning of each round is a great way to get the height that we need when working with trebles. And I would challenge even the most eagle-eyed person to find the first treble of each of these rounds. If you made a set of four or six of these, they would make fab stocking fillers. Or at Christmas, I always make my own crackers, and these would fit perfectly inside, and the recipient would never guess what was in there. I personally think they look great as a set made up of five colours, with each of the coasters made from a different colour sequence, but they look equally as fantastic using bright, vivid colours. The centre round uses such a tiny amount of wool that you'll never want to throw away any of your scraps again. So now that we've completed our 11 trebles for the side of the coaster, we're going to be doing our corner sequence, and just in case you've forgotten it, it's two treble, one chain, two treble into the same space, and then we just continue around the round with the sequence of trebles down the side and the corner sequence until we get to the final treble, and then we work a slip stitch as before into the top of that dummy treble to close the round. You will see on the final round that we are working in a different stitch along the edge, and we have a very slightly different variation on the corner. Along the edge we will be working a double crochet, and again we will still be working into the back loop of the stitch only, and then the corner sequence is made up of three trebles, one double treble, and three more trebles all in the same space, and it creates a little bit of a fan in the corner. So let's get started on the next round. To start the round, you need to work a double crochet into the back stitch of one of the previous round's side trebles. It doesn't really matter where you start along the side, as long as you don't start too close to the corners. You then need to work along the row with double crochets into the back of those trebles, but make sure that you stop before you get to the corner trebles. So in the corners you work two treble, one chain, two treble, but we don't want to work any double crochets in any of those stitches, so we need to stop just before we get to them. So we need to work the double crochet up to the corner trebles. Then we need to work the sequence into the corner. So the sequence is three trebles into that corner space. Double treble So wrap the yarn around the hook twice. Insert it into the corner space, yarn over, pull the hook through. Yarn over, pull the first two loops off the hook, yarn over, second two loops off the hook, yarn over, and the last two loops off the hook. And then we need to work three trebles into that same corner space. And that is our corner fan created. We then need to miss the two trebles that made up the corner of the previous round. And as before, when working the side trebles, the first one is tucked round the corner. So we need to miss those two and then work double crochets in the back loops, back up the second side until we get to the corner again. And we then need to work the corner sequence of three treble, one double treble, three treble. And we simply continue all the way around the round with those two sequences, the side sequence of double crochet and the corner sequence, until we get back round to the first double crochet of the round. Having worked the sequence in this round, we close the round with a slip stitch into the back loop of the first double crochet we worked. All you now need to do is tie the ends at the back, sew them in securely, and cut the visible tails off. And you now have completed your coaster. We hope you enjoyed our tutorial, and we always love seeing our creations being made. So please tag us at The Crafty Co, and we'll be back here soon.